have the right as a plain general. A right a lot of people say, no, I'm not going to vote for this. But it's very, very, very simple. Because in this country, of course, most of the right are free masons, and we're also very directly involved.
I know one thing, like all the youths here, I know right from wrong, and I know when people get dragged out 3 o'clock in the morning, when there's people getting shot in this beautiful city, where people died in 1916 for the rights, and they come in, take innocent people, where's your politicians? They're going over to America, they're going everywhere. Why didn't one of them come down here last night and talk to the people? Why did they have to send in so many guardies, smashing people up? Talk to the people. Hundreds of years of oppression and avoiding talking to the people. For God's sake.
How to do the judges on.
Short sentences.
I would like to know, why you are standing here.
Why are you standing here?
I'm standing here for consideration because it's jobs and everything for
and education.
That's the way we are today. That's it. More people to put on their asses and fuck with their mouths. Party is going to be from what they're fucking doing. And you deserve it. That's it.
Something like keep people in ignorance, you know?
Well, I mean, the Romans said, if you give them bread and circuses, they'll never evolve.
Like most people here, like most people here, so that the Irish state,
so that the Irish state
won't be able to drive this movement off the streets.
Won't be able to drive this movement off the streets.
6 months ago, it was started by a small number of people. But since the budget last December, this country has erupted in protest. There are thousands of people marching. In small rural villages. To defend their schools.
To defend
their hospitals. To fight against this government's austerity. What we need to do is link all those movements together. What the state did here last night can reinvigorate this movement. And it shows you the reality of what the police and the state is about. They try and put themselves across as the guardians of the peace. But really, they're the guardians of the billionaires and the millionaires. And we're not going to have it anymore. Keep on marching. Let's all strike together to get rid of this austerity.
Proposal here.
Revolution.
We need it.
That's what happens. Yeah, we'll have
more batteries.
I would like to propose that we reoccupy. This plaza. And any other square. Or group space.
Any other space that we are so allowed to do.
Would anyone like to talk about this proposal?
Guess
not.
Don't be shy now.
What are the squares? Here and where? What are the squares? And anywhere else?
Okay, so we have a proposal to reoccupy this square. Yeah! Is there anyone who's against it and would like to stand aside? Is there anyone who would like to block it? Okay, let's look for consensus. Raise your hands.
Occupy Dame Street all day, all week. Occupy Dame Street all day.
any clear consensus?
Got clear consensus?
To reoccupy this plaza!
To reoccupy this plaza!
I want to tell you all something very, very important.
Over two weeks ago,
the state solicitor's office was notified of our intent.
Was notified of our intent
to take a constitutional challenge.
To take a constitutional challenge
on the fiscal treaty.
On the fiscal treaty
to force the government to have a referendum.
To force the government to have a referendum.
They had 2 weeks to respond to us under the Freedom of Information Act.
They had 2 weeks to respond to us under the Freedom of Information Act.
On the day of the 2 weeks was up, the government decided to have a referendum.
The government decided to have a referendum.
On that same day, we got a letter from the police.
On that same day, we got a letter from the police.
The moving of us from this spot is purely political.
The moving of us from this spot is purely political.
Also, we went to the IMF Troika press conference. It's still up on the IMF website.
It's still up on the IMF website.
But RTE removed it. We challenged. The ECB, the central bank which is under the control of the ECB. The policies being pursued by the EU.
The policies being pursued by the EU.
Of privatising bank profits.
Of privatising bank profits.
And placing the losses on our back. Is crippling Ireland and will bankrupt us. We asked the IMF, the EU, and the ECB. Was this the new face of EU fascism? By inference, we are saying that they are. This was removed by Irish authorities, but not by the IMF. We are torn now in their side. And we intend making it a stake through their heart. This is only beginning. We are not going to stand by while the Irish people carry this burden on their back. They broke EU law when they forced us to do the bailout under Article 123, 125 of the Lisbon Treaty. They broke the law. When they forced us to do the bailout. Under Article
123, 125.
Of the Lisbon Treaty. They also broke international law. Under odious debt. These people broke the law. We want them taken to account.
Okay, I'm going to open up for questions or proposals.
Any questions?
questions or comments.
Folks, I'd like to invite everyone.